1 Cup Final Cricket with highlights of today's match between Warwickshire and Worcestershire. Introduced now by Tony Lewis.
Benson Hedges Cup Final. Wonderful atmosphere at Lord's this morning, and not only because there was £31,000 at stake and the Gold Cup, of course, but also Warwickshire versus Worcestershire, very much the local derby. Of course, Warwickshire were looking to one very special young man to succeed, Brian Lara, a record breaker in Test and County cricket. He'd never played a Lord's final before.
It's my first year in County cricket, and it would be my first Benson Hedges final, and playing under such a large crowd, not for West Indies, playing for Warwickshire, it'll be something different for me, and I'll be looking forward to it, and hopefully we could do ourselves justice.
Yes, welcome to the highlights, and Warwickshire are favourites, not only because of Brian Lara's presence, but because of their last 15 one-day matches, they have lost only one. Well, the toss is crucial at Lord's. I was out there at the start with the captains, Dermot Reeve and Tim Curtis.
We'll have a bowl.
Right. Who won the toss?
Cheers. Warwickshire won the toss and will field.
Any doubts in your mind, Dermot?
No, not really. There's a bit of moisture in it. Hopefully it'll go around a bit early on. Just hopefully Worcester won't make 321.
The battle begins here, I think, Tim.
Yeah, it's nice with the sun shining, because there is a little bit of moisture there, but I think the sun comes out, it'll be hot, and hopefully that will minimise any effect on the pitch.
It doesn't feel like one of those sort of infamous mornings at Lord's where it's all moisture and all movement, does it?
No, it felt like that about an hour ago. But this, as Tim says, the sun's come out, and I think it'll play pretty well. But I think it'll be a good surface and hold together throughout, so don't mind chasing.
No problems on selection?
No, Gladstone's come through. He's had a little bit of a dodgy hamstring, but he's through, and we're as on the scorecard.
And Tim, Adam Seymour comes in to open the batting?
Yeah, it's been a little bit of a problem area for me, just trying to decide who's going to be our best bet there. He's had a couple of good knocks in one-day cricket this year, and he's a good player, so I hope that he'll respond to the occasion.
Good, thanks.
Let's see the teams then. Worcestershire have 7 Test cricketers there, but Rhodes, of course, is the current one, the England wicketkeeper. Plenty of seam bowling and Illingworth for spin. And Warwickshire, 4 Test cricketers. In form with the bat is Roger Tooze as well as Brian Lara, and plenty of all-round talent. No one better than Dermot Reeve, the captain. The umpires, Harold Bird and Ken Palmer. Reminder, Warwickshire won the toss, are fielding first. And the pitch, well, Paul Allett was our man out there to inspect it this morning.
Well, there's a greenish tinge to this pitch. A little bit of moisture in it as well, I feel. And the key will go in quite substantially. Halfway there, which indicates that I think there'll be a little bit of movement early on for the seam bowlers. Could be a little bit of variety and variation in bounce as well. The ball bounces quite well in some areas and not so well in others. Could be a little bit difficult to bat on early on.
Let's join the Worcestershire innings then. The first over, it's the second ball. Small bowls to Seymour, 1 run on the board.
There's a nice confident start. A lot of conjecture as to whether Seymour would play in this match or whether it would be Philip Weston.
Adam Seymour will be very pleased to get underway in this manner. Beautiful straight drive, timed beautifully, picked up 3 runs.
Oh, nicely placed. That'll run very fast down the hill. That's a terrific first over for the Worcestershire side, put into bat on what looks so far anyway, Paul, to be a pretty good track.
Yeah, there's been nothing in this pitch to suggest
adverse movement. It's a good shot by Tim Curtis.
That's a pretty good eye. Good piece of judgment by Adam Seymour.
And that is the finish for Adam Seymour. Tim Mutton has struck the first blow. Looked to me that Seymour was aiming to jolt it away through mid-wicket. And Mutton has done it. Not just to flip the pad. Probably need the replay to give us a clear definition of that.
After a super piece of judgment, the ball before, that's nipped down the hill. He's looking to hit that too square on the leg side. It's clipped the top of middle and off. That's clean through.
He's just straightened that right pad a fraction there. The ball must have got through the tiniest of gaps. 10 for one wicket. Batsman still to come. Graham Hick, who's next in, then Tom Moody. Tom Holmes and Leatherdale, and Graham Hick on his way out to the centre net. One of the reasons every ticket has been sold. Holder of world record test match score, 375 and 501 in the game against Durham.
Fine delivery from Gladstone Small. He's nipped that one back up the Lord's slope. Too much and too high to be LBW, but nevertheless a very fine delivery.
Shows good quick reflexes.
Jags back down the slope, pad flat, bat and boot away from the stumps.
Good shot. Nice crisp stroke. Got a pretty much off the meat of the bat. To be able to confidence boost. Worcestershire suddenly found the ball was going past the inside edge and hitting the pad, and now they've got one way down the ground to the boundary.
Well, Gladstone Small's taking his second slip away. If he bowls any more like that, he's going to put one back in. That's gone away and bounced. Tim Curtis beaten on the outside edge.
It's the one he's been waiting for. That field is very fast. Been a bit of rain in London, but not enough to slow it down. And he got that away very, very well.
It's a good shot.
And this game and the match situation ideally suited to Tim Curtis. Plays the anchor role. That's the Moody's and Hicks come and play round him, and if Worcestershire wanted to be beginnings from the captain, it's today. That's a Hicks shot. It's more than a firm push, but it wasn't a great big slot by any means, but the power of the man when he gets something like that is immense.
Well, again, a little bit of room for Graham Hick to use his arms.
Beautifully bowled and caught. Piper takes the catch. Curtis goes, small strikes. And now the second Worcestershire wicket down.
Well, what a moment for Gladstone Small. He's niggled away around the off stump all morning. He's overpitched on a couple of occasions when Curtis has driven him, but he's been prepared to keep the ball up to the bat. Committing Curtis to the shot, the ball holding its line as it so often does when you bowl from the nursery end at Lord's, and Curtis just maybe pushing at it a little, but a wonderful catch. Piper balling away to his right in a very big wicket.
Shot, or would you call it good bowling, or a bit of both? Not a good over from Munton. He went past Hick, he bothered Moody there. Those were his figures. Now, what mark do you do as a captain? Do you let them go still further into their 11 overs?
Oh, yes. No question at the moment that the big threat is coming from these two classy new ball performers. This is the standard break. Hick and Moody, the two internationals. Gladstone Small, who, as you said, has had a hamstring strain. There's no point in him seizing up now. He wants to keep attacking. The concept that run saving wins limited over matches is well defeated by the one that wickets taken, particularly of the top order, certainly win limited overs matches.
Oh, that is as good as you've seen this morning. That's the end of the over. Only 32 for two. Three singles scored in the partnership.
Hardly say that Dermot Reeves in the gullies, but it's almost short third man.
Well, that's the position. It's a run-saving position. Always there for the slash square drive that goes behind square.
Good cricket all round. Nothing wrong with the ball. Graham Hick deliberately slamming that down into the turf. Dermot Reeves very athletic there. Catch and throw all in one movement. Good cricket.
Very well controlled. It was dropped short by Small and beautifully played by Graham Hick. He had to watch the ball so carefully because it didn't really get up. And a controlled shot without flourish. Don't say it, Gladstone, don't say it. Whatever you do, don't say it.
It's a fine delivery, isn't it? Down the hill again. Tom Moody pushing at that one.
55 overs aside, and 11 overs he's bowled for the maidens. One for 26. We knew he came in nursing an injury, and that's why his captain kept him going right through 11 on the trot. And that's good bowling, Paul Allott.
Yeah, it's a marvellous spell of bowling. There's been a little bit in this pitch all morning, and Gladstone Small has exploited it. He's gone out past the outside edge of the bat numerous occasions. The Gladstone Small fan club down there warmly applauding him as he receives them with a wave. He'll be mightily pleased.
For two off 22 overs, and excellent bowling we've seen from Gladstone Small. And Tim Munton bowled 9 in his 11 for 15.
Oh, that's well bowled, and that's out. Graham Hick goes. Very well bowled by Paul Smith. And Graham Hick had played really well. He'd got out there and he'd counted the ball, which was steaming, moving off the pitch. Let's take a look at this.
And this one's nipped back at him down the hill. Hit him in front of middle stump. His feet going nowhere.
It's 55 for three, and Worcestershire are in the 24th over.
Well, the big advantage of Reeve is his ability to move the ball around. He wouldn't get away with bowling at this gentle pace unless he did, and he bowls the outswinger, the leg cutter, slower ball, and the inswinger. So he has a real variety.
And Brian Lara's moved into slip.
Magnificent blow. Such a strong player. And as mentioned a little earlier, a great driver of the ball.
It's a wonderful stroke, hitting the ball on the up, just as the ball gets to the rise of its bounce, smashing through it with terrific power. Big difference in the field for these two batsmen. Reeves out, swingers. Deserving six fielders on the offside for Haynes. He'll probe away on an outside off stump. Just about there.
Delightful piece of cricket. Great delivery. Cut away down the hill. A wonderful piece of wicket-keeping, standing up over the stumps there. Beautifully taken with his hands completely relaxed. Keith Piper's the keeper. There's a good ball. Good ball. Nice little, slightly slower in-ducker. Ian Botham, ex-cricketer and present-day golfer. He's back to us. Alan Lamb is there as well. Nicholas means about the way Haynes approaches his game. Very much the aggressor and a thinker as well. And he's done him. Gavin Haynes goes. Neil Smith has taken the wicket. And that is a crucial breakthrough straight after the luncheon interval. He made 22 and looked good. And he faced 47 balls, and that was all at a crucial time so far as the Worcestershire side is concerned.
Gavin Haynes looking to give himself a bit of room and chop this away on the offside. Turned. Just got the outside edge, and Keith Piper takes the catch.
100 for four now. Leatherdale is the new batsman coming out to join Tom Moody. And that should be four.
Well, Roger Tews had spent a minute or so rearranging his field before he bowled that first ball and slipped in the leg side. Quite a wide, well-controlled shot.
Well done. Well caught. And there's a look from one umpire to the other, but Leatherdale still has to go. He swung it around. It wasn't a bouncer as such. It was just short-pitched. Leatherdale is gone.
Sums up this quality cricket from Warwickshire. Oh, bounced a little bit. Leatherdale's got underneath it.
That's a super tumbling catch by Dominic Ostler down at fine leg. Quite big on David Leatherdale. Bounced more than he expected. A good tumbling catch.
124 for five, and now Worcestershire have real problems. Stephen Rhodes is the man coming out.
Caught him on the crease, nipping back, would have hit middle and off.
Stuart Lampett is the incoming batsman.
Roger Tooze has been appealing merrily all afternoon, and he's finally been rewarded, and that is as plumb as they come.
Terrific effort there by Paul Smith. But almost stuck. I mean, it's one of those that really had to hit the middle of the palm and stick. That's in the air, and that's out. Either the leading edge of the bat or the shoulder, but Paul Smith gets the reward again for digging the ball in short. A little bit of lift at the other end. And Lampett goes, Worcestershire really in disarray now. Here's Mark Nicholas.
Well, the one thing Worcester have is a resilient middle order, but they're suffering here. Steepling bounce, Stuart Lampett looking to work the ball away on the leg side for a single, and Paul Smith, who has got a yard of extra pace above the other Warwickshire bowlers, surprising him.
Well, we said that Steve Rhodes was the perfect man for this job, and look where he is now. But you'd also say that Richard Illingworth is one of the best equipped to play to a partner like Tom Moody. I talked about the man who gets on the front foot and plays the dead bat and plays to the senior player.
Perfect, you see. Quite clearly that private intercom you've got with Richard Illingworth is failing.
That's got some real pace up here. Very well played, in fact. Dropped the hands and the gloves. Really good spell by Paul Smith. All rested on his shoulders, and just see what that young man Penny's done.
Well, Richard Illingworth here looking to do just as Tony Lewis suggested, drop in and run, but he's testing one of the really good fielders in the country. Trevor Penny, a young Zimbabwean, who was brought up in their tradition of they're hitting one stump there in Colin Bland mode. They go again. Oh dear, dear. Oh, this is desperation stakes there. And all for a single.
There's one golden rule, and that is that all 55 overs must be batted. Every ball available to Worcestershire must be used. And insane singles at this stage are not the order of the day. But that has barely made it into the frame.
That's a rare error, and it's given two runs.
Sloppy stuff for the first time today. No backing up. Asif Din quite making the ground he ought to. Neil Smith throwing needlessly. Look at that. That's way off target.
He's got hold of that. Haven't been many fours in this innings, only nine of them, that's number 10.
The one problem that Dermot Reeve has with the field set as it was is that if his third man is up, his square cover is up and his extra cover is up, he has to bowl the ball very straight. He can't risk bowling it just outside off stump, so the batsman can set himself safely to hit it away on the leg side, and there is that big gap in most of us call cow corner, I suppose. And one thing Neil Radford does do is strike the ball quite beautifully.
There it goes. He's dropped his bat. Going back for it. He's not. Now then. If he wants to face the next ball, he'd better go and get it.
Have a look at this. Super shot. Smashes it away down the ground. Now Neil Radford here, what actually happened was he dropped his bat and wasn't sure that he'd made his ground, forgetting of course that his bat counted as part of his body.
Got him, LBW. Shot he tried before, really, the sweep against the slower pace of Dermot Reeve. So the end of a good innings from Illingworth, the end of a good partnership. 168 for 9.
Well, not only is that a ball without a run being scored, but it's a ball that Neil Radford hasn't been able to face. Richard Illingworth may well have been better settling for the single.
Three balls of the innings left, and just look what Worcestershire have or haven't done since they were put into bat this morning. Dermot Reeve winning a toss in his fourth final, second as captain. Blazing start, 8 runs from the first over of Gladstone Small, and then it all went into reverse. So one ball of the innings left, Radford on 22, Reeve to bowl to him. A lot of alterations of the field. 5 men out on the boundary. Waited for it. Slower one from Reeve. Gets the single. Radford on 23. Reeve will be happy. Worcestershire will be happier. At least they got to 170.
Well, however, Graham Hick and Tom Moody tried to make a solid performance there in the middle.
really it was a stumbling performance all round by Worcestershire. The best partnerships between Moody and Haynes for 45 and Radford and Illingworth for 42. But all the time they struggled in the face of the moving ball and at one stage lost four wickets in 21 balls for 2 runs. And as for the bowlers, well, terrific start given by Small and Munton, no doubt about that. Gladstone Small bowling 11 overs on the trot, 1 for 26. Paul Smith got the wickets in the middle, 3 for 34, aggressive and accurate. And really everyone chipped in, a good all-round bowling performance by Warwickshire. And so that leaves Warwickshire 171 runs to win at 3.1 runs per over.
A big task now for Worcestershire. They're seam bowlers. I would imagine the pitch will play exactly as it has done all day, which is in favour of seam bowling. And their seam bowlers, Bill Newport and Neil Radford, have a big chance. And so too does Tom Moody, who's been given the new ball.
Moody's a miserly medium pacer. That's not too miserly. A nice, gentle long hop outside off stump. Thumped through the covers.
A good stroke down the hill towards the tavern, and it'll be too fast for the fielder. One of the worst places to field. You always think you're about to overtake the ball, and it always gets away from you. Leaves you standing sometimes.
Positive approach by Osler. Whipping that off middle and off down this slope towards the tavern boundary. Beautifully placed, beautifully timed.
It's four ball. That's not going to please anyone in the Worcestershire side, particularly Moody, I suppose, but it's certainly his captain's not going to be happy. It's given him the new ball and he's had 3 boundaries struck off it.
Dominic Osler is an aggressive player. He loves to go for his shots right from the word go. He's been given an ideal opportunity by Tom Moody, who's pitched that short, swiveled into a pull, away high over square leg. Dickie Bird, evasive action from the umpire. 3 boundaries in the first 2 overs from Tom Moody.
Different complexion on the game.
A marvellous shot. Gorgeous free flow of the bat from Roger Twos.
This will be interesting. Stuart Lampert has come on for Phil Newport. Lampert has always struck me as being someone who normally is very accurate. He's got one up in the air, and it's catchable.
Well, that's gone up and up, way up in the air towards backward square leg. You can see Stephen Rhodes setting off for it. Richard Illingworth, the man, scampering after it. Fine legs giving it up, and it's just landed in the middle of them.
Got the faintest of inside edges past the wicket keeper. He showed what he'd do within the short when Tom Moody bowled one at him, ran about the same length. Not so accurate, Stuart.
He's given him the chance to play that shot again, and he's done it beautifully this time. Onto the back foot, swivelling away. It's gone in front of square for 4.
Beautiful 4. Oh, that's a good shot. played a couple of vicious pull shots. And that was a classy cover drive.
Not allowing the bowlers any margin for error. Lampitt just slightly over-pitching, bit of width. He's launched into that with a beautiful extra cover drive off the front foot.
Worth a try, but nothing really goes right for Worcestershire in the field.
Bit of a delay in setting off, bit of hesitation. Once they had set off, out if they'd hit. But then overthrows.
Good shot. And that's been the big difference. They haven't just tried to work hard singles away. They've tried to play really positive attacking strokes.
Well, if we have a look here, I think we'll see Phil Newport conceding four, not being aware of him, of it himself quite genuinely, and getting away with a run. Dive. The ball probably hit the rope anyway. He's moved the rope back.
His foot was over the line as he picked it up, but at the same time, I think he conceded that the ball might have rolled onto the rope. It doesn't look a very calculated pickup. No serious. But Dickie's.
Yes.
As if he's discovered something quite dramatic. Third umpire has become all part of the entertainment. Dominic Oster, good forthright cover drive. The applause round the ground for the half-century partnership. A reverse sweep. Well, everything they've attempted has come off. If you get that shot wrong, you look a mug, but everything that's been tried today by Warwickshire has come off totally.
Ryan Lara, pound it up. Enough said, really.
Super shot. Wide of it on, just wide of the fielder. Beautifully timed. And good to watch for everyone except Neil Radford or anybody supporting Worcestershire.
Wonderful shot from Dominic Osser. He's thumped a dead straight ball of a foolish length. Wide of mid on with almost Viv Richards-like panache and timing.
Well, he smashed that away down to the tavern stand. One thing I like about their stroke play, and they share this, is an absolute commitment to the stroke once they've decided to attack.
That's 50. Second in the competition. There's an appeal there, and certainly looks as though umpire Palmer's asking for assistance. The crowd are applauding the 50. Let's see what happened.
Well, it's a dangerous run. It's born out of frustration, not getting to 50 quickly enough. Good bit of fielding. Curtis very quick to the ball, a good flat throw. Who would be an umpire?
think I'd rather bet that he was out than in, but we don't have to make the decision. And he's given him in. There were cheers, and now comes the acknowledgement from Dominic Osler of his 50. Relieved smiles from up there. Otherwise, twos would have been back and he would still be on 49. It's as tight as you could ever get. Oh, that's worth a big shout. Umpire Bird says no.
The twos putting in a big stride. Pitched on leg. Not to be too far away to me.
Often you see left-handers play that shot, but Roger Tews, as I was saying before, is a great improviser against spin. Trouble and out. Osler accepting a call which Tews finally withdrew. And as has nearly been the case on two or three occasions, a run out and the first wicket 91 for one.
Well, the understanding that these two have built up through this innings and this season, finally proving their downfall here as Roger Tews pushes into the offside, looks to set off and then says no, but it's too late. Dominic Osler stranded in mid-pitch. It's a good pickup. Comes in, Graham Hick, ideally positioned behind the stumps.
This is the man they've waited for. Let's hear the reception, Brian Lara. Four, just one short of that. I'll just make the point about Brian Lara while we're watching this gorgeous off drive is that he's got a natural scoring rate of around a run a ball. Not only from the fielders, but from umpire Palmer to the third umpire.
And judging by Roger Tews' reaction, he slammed his bat into the turf as he got past the bowler's end there. I think he thinks he's out. Just delayed it a little bit.
It was his call. Now we'll watch it. Oh, he can keep going. That spoiled his tee time. No question of that. And what a finish for Worcestershire to get both openers, both run out in the last 10 minutes before tea.
What about that then?
Lovely little piece of improvisation by Brian Lara.
It's in position so quickly, well across to off stump. High back lift and that flick with the roll of the wrist.
Very difficult for right-arm bowler to get an OBW coming over the wicket. Needs to pitch it in line and have it straighten a little. Good! Done! He's away! Newport has got him.
Well, that's the wicket Worcester wanted. Brian Lara departs for eight. Caught hit ball Newport. Newport bowled a good over. Tightened up his line. Kept Lara tucked up. Brian Lara's looking to flick this away on the leg side. It's just stopped on him a fraction. But all he did was scoop it to Graham Hick at mid-wicket. Brian Lara's backlift and aggression, his willingness to hit the ball hard, just didn't contribute to his downfall there.
Suddenly the crowd has come to life. In a low-scoring fixture so far. They've just seen three wickets fall. Now they've almost seen a fourth.
Well, Smith just gets the cue end on that.
It's given that a bit. You had some room there, offered by Phil Newport, well outside off stump, and absolutely threw the bat at it.
Well, it's really poor bowling from Newport. That really is wide, and Paul Smith just gives it a full flow of the bat.
On paper anyway, Warwick are absolutely steaming away with it, 113 for three, but there is just a little bit of nervous tension out there now. They've lost three top players, Dominic Ostler, and then Toussaint Lara. Again, but very, very effective. No great respecter of bowlers.
A good straight thump up in the slot. Deciding that that had to go. The benefit of hitting straight, though. Kept his head down. Bottom hand came in a bit. Evaded mid on.
Safe, lucky, but quite safe. Exactly what's needed to get over the little touch of nerves when those three wickets went down.
He's looking to hit this straight again. Seamed on him a little bit. Ended up looping high over slip. If you're going to flash, flash hard.
Slippery time there. Just a question of did that get to his left hand on the full?
If it did, it would have been a remarkable catch. It did.
It's worth runs, but it might have been worth a wicket. Already we've had two run-outs, and David Leatherdale shaking his head there.
One of the things that county cricket has practiced an awful lot of their time is exactly this. The little push into the covers, the run round the ball, one-handed shy with the hope of the direct hit. David Leatherdale hasn't had a direct hit today.
Just look what Paul Smith's doing. Really has got a lot of character in his cricket. Not afraid of anything or any match situation. At times impetuosity has cost him his wicket doing things like this. Unless Worcestershire can suddenly grab a hatful of wickets, then
finals on its way, Warwickshire's way.
Things like that, just deflections are going right. Worcestershire couldn't find a gap. Warwickshire, they're all suddenly all over the place.
Yeah, the key here, though, is the line of the ball. It nips back way, going way down the hill, would have missed leg stump by some margin. It did bounce a little, which is why Asif Din got it high, almost on the gloves. In fact, on the gloves, you can see that as he whips his bottom hand off the bat. So Lampitt being a shadow of the bowler who won the quarter-final for his county at Derbyshire, taking six wickets, an inspired spell of seam bowling. And today just has never really found the rhythm that makes him such an awkward little competitor.
And that's out. There's a wicket. Orthodox outside edge. Moody gets his man. Din goes. And now 147 for four in the 38th.
Asif Din, just for about the first time going on the big drive. The key there was that his foot didn't get anywhere near the ball. In fact, it hardly moves. He barely moves from his initial position of stance before winding himself to hit the ball probably over mid-off, at a guess. But poor footwork contributing to that downfall. He's shuffled back. He hasn't moved much there from the position he started in. And it brings to the crease that most entertaining and colourful and the wild of cricketers, Warwickshire captain Dermot Reid.
...150 up. There goes Smith. It's a great flourish, that. And it's not quite a deadlock, but he certainly broke a little bit of stalemate there since Dermot Reid came in. Nothing had happened. Only three runs in as many overs, and suddenly Smith does that.
He does hit through the ball quite beautifully. I mentioned earlier Ian Botham. Look at that finish position. See what you think. He gets up on that front toe.
Well, Lampitt joined in there. I think the wicketkeeper led him. And it was a little bit of little Sir Echo.
Yeah, very optimistic shout. Ball clearly missing leg stump. But a bit of movement off the seam still.
Well, Reeves had enough of having naught against his name. The thing to note here is the footwork. The time he decides that it's due for the charge.
The great thing there is that he gave himself enough room to let his arms flow at the ball.
What is Paul Smith doing now? Stirring way to finish.
Well, now, the match needed some batting like this. Jackie's played with great skill too, because when he came in, as you rightly observed, there was just enough of a tremor. Three quick wickets, so that's the back of the handball, incidentally, from Neil Radford, that Paul Smith latches on too quickly. But the match certainly needed some real stroke play to delight the crowd in the evening sunshine.
Got it. That might be it, and is. And Warwickshire win the 1994 Benson and Hedges Cup by six wickets with 10 overs and four balls to spare. There's a delighted Smith. He's got two stumps. Whether he'll keep them is another matter. But it's been a very good team effort by Warwickshire. And one really that came from the grip that they established on the match right from the word go.
The big opening partnership between Ostler and Tooze set it up, 91 runs for them, and then the two run-outs and the Lara chip to mid-wicket really threatened to hand over the initiative, but Paul Smith truly saw them through, 172 for four. Worcestershire, well, it was a struggle for them. The pick of the bowling was Tom Moody, 11 overs, two maidens, one for 31. Wickets to Moody and to Newport, but I'm afraid, on the whole, unimpressive. So Warwickshire win the 23rd Benson & Hedges Cup final by six wickets with 10 overs to spare. Dermot Reeve accepted the trophy on the balcony afterwards. The cheque for £31,000, a true all-rounder, and in fact, a leader by example. Sir Richard Hadley announced the winner of the Gold Award, Paul Smith, for his 3-34 and 42 not out of 42 balls. And after I spoke to Paul Smith and to his captain, Dermot Reeve.
Well, Dermot, congratulations. Another fantastic success for you.
Thank you, Tony. Yeah, it's been a very good day. We played good cricket today.
What about the toss? That was crucial this morning?
Yeah, I think it was very important. But then you still got to bowl well. And Gladstone had a bit of a hamstring problem, so he wasn't 100%. So it was good for him to, you know, get his 11 straight off and bowl him for 26.
I must say, you played very positive cricket, and this young man did quite well for you.
Yeah, he's a man for the big occasion. He's always batted well on every Lord's visit, and he likes doing well against Worcester. But today he bowled really well and batted positively, and nice for him to have a bit of gold in his pocket.
Well, Paul, it's nice to call someone who's about to have a benefit a young man, but well played.
Thank you very much indeed. It's very good for the people down there. You know, very good for the Midlands. You know, as we said, we just went out to try and play positive cricket, and things went our way. And thankfully, Dermot's carrying a bit of gold in his hand.
What was it out there in the morning in the pitch for the seam bowlers?
It swung about and it did a little bit off the seam. But I mean, as you say, you've got to get the ball in the right place. If you don't get the ball in the right place to some of their players, they're gonna smack you all around the ground. So you know, we thought that we'd done a pretty good job, but it was only halfway done, and we went out and batted positively, and thankfully, we've ended up as winners.
One last thought, Captain. There's a hint of self-destruction about the first couple of wickets today, when you had a trial route, then you had two runouts, and I suddenly thought, oh dear.
I know, I've had a chat with Roger, and he admits he's let his fitness slip a little bit, and he was actually feeling really tired out there. I mean, he's an excellent cricketer. I think he's a definite England prospect. Had a really good game plan, but he just lost it a bit there. He was a bit fatigued, and he says he's to blame, you know, for both runouts, and we had that little hiccup. But as we show, we're not a one-man team, and we came through.
Well, our next cricket is here at Lord's, coming up on 21st of July. That's the historic return of the South Africans to test match play in this country, the first of three test matches against England. But tonight, after the Benson & Hedges Cup final, the toast is Warwickshire and Paul Smith.
Y'all ready for this?